Good morning. Sydney has been hit by a terror attack. A Christian leader allegedly stabbed multiple times by a 16-year-old boy while giving a sermon at the altar of Christ the Good Shepherd Church in Wakeley in Sydney's west. The whole incident captured online on a church live stream. New South Wales police this morning declaring the attack as an act of terror.
At 1:35 a.m. this morning, after consideration of all the material, I declared that it was a terrorist incident. Strike Force Katrina has been established to investigate that side of the events last night.
Let's go straight to reporter Erin Ramsey, who's out the front of the church. Erin, how is the community reacting after it was declared an act of terror?
Kate, this community is shocked, and that is putting it lightly. Members of the church that I've spoken to this morning, well, they are first and foremost incredibly concerned over the welfare of Bishop Mari Emmanuel. It's understood the 53-year-old was conducting a Bible session here at the church, Christ the Good Shepherd Church here at Wakeley around 7 p.m. last night, when he was allegedly attacked by a 15-year-old male. It's in that moment that members of that service rushed over not only to tend to the bishop, but to also try and restrain that 15-year-old until authorities could arrive. Now, in that time as well, a large mob of thousands began to gather outside the church, making it incredibly difficult for police to enter and also for paramedics to get in and treat the bishop. It's understood that during that commotion, another member of the church, Father Isaac Royale, was also injured. So a lot of people in there needing medical attention, but it was incredibly difficult for police to make their way in as that mob started to become destructive, smashing police cars, climbing on top of vehicles, using bricks and ripping off fences of nearby homes to cause a bit of chaos there, as well as that scene just continued to explode and leaving surrounding neighbours absolutely rattled.
There were thousands of people, hundreds of police and riot squad. The majority were calm and civil, but there was a significant small portion of very angry people. They were arriving from all over Sydney, and they just wanted blood.
It's disastrous, yeah. In a world that we're living in, or what happened in Bondi, the hate that's in this world is taking an enormous toll on everyone.
It doesn't feel safe at all. We are scared. I'm scared. My kids are scared.
Okay, as you can imagine, the scale and escalation of this situation has our leaders talking this morning, both the Prime Minister and New South Wales Premier sharing their words on the issue, and that it will not be tolerated in Australia.
This is a disturbing incident. There is no place for violence in our community. There is no place for violent extremism. We are a peace-loving nation. This is a time to unite, not divide, as a community and as a country.
This is a major and serious criminal investigation. It is crucial that New South Wales Police are able to devote their resources and intelligence, as well as officers, to the investigation of this crime. I want to make something very, very clear. There is no such thing in Australia in taking the law into your own hands.
And Kate, as for the church, well, that very much remains an active crime scene. Detectives and forensic crews still on the scene now. And that 15-year-old boy, he is right now under police guard in hospital, where he has now been arrested. Kate?
Erin Ramsey, thank you. Let's go to Jack Hahn at Liverpool Hospital in Sydney's southwest, where some of the injured have been taken. Jack, dozens have been treated there, including the bishop. What's the latest on their condition?
Kate, good morning to you. There are 7 patients in hospitals across Sydney, from police officers to a parishioner and the alleged perpetrator. The bishop is here at Liverpool Hospital overnight. A vigil was held by some of his followers praying for a speedy recovery, and this morning he is in a stable condition after undergoing surgery. A man in his 30s is also here and is also stable. Those 2 police officers have been hospitalised, one for a broken jaw, the other for a twisted knee. As for the teenager, he is not here at Liverpool Hospital. Instead, he is at an undisclosed location receiving hospital treatment. It's understood he has undergone emergency surgery for significant injuries to his hand. Kate, 30 patients were treated by ambulance paramedics, 20 for the use of pepper spray and related injuries, but many of them were able to make their own way home. Kate.
All right, Jack, we'll leave it there. Thank you. 3 days since the shocking attack at Bondi Junction, flowers with messages of tribute are still being laid outside the Westfield as victims, loved ones and complete strangers pay their respects. Hayley Francis is there. Hayley, the centre remains closed, but so many have been visiting the scene.
That's right, Kate. The outpouring of grief has just been non-stop here this morning outside Westfield. So many people have been laying these beautiful tributes. Every few minutes, there is another beautiful bouquet of flowers which is added to this pile. Like you said, some people, strangers, they didn't know any of these victims, and other people did know these beautiful six lives that were taken, and they simply have worked up the courage to come here, and it's been a very emotional experience for them. We also saw that the sails of the iconic Sydney Opera House were illuminated last night as a mark of remembrance for what has been such a horrific time for our city, our community. This is something that so many people have told me this morning has left their hearts just so heavy, and so that people really are just banding together and doing what they can to heal in really what they only have control over right now. Take a listen to just some of those experiences people have spoken to us today, including some of the workers who were inside on Saturday who have worked up the courage to come here today. Take a listen.
I was working, and then one moment I just heard my co-worker that she's shouting, "Get out, get out," and I was like, "Okay, what happened, what happened?" And I saw people started like running for their lives.
I'm a local, and it's just hard to put into words how some of these people are feeling and how this happens, and it's just a travesty.
It's very heavy. It's very sad.
It really does speak to the, you know, how fragile life can be. It is just unbelievable.
We're also hearing more and more about the heroic efforts of those who tried to fend off killer Joel Cauchy, including the French national Damien, otherwise known as Bollard Man, the Prime Minister weighing in on that today. Take a listen.
It says a lot about the nature of humanity at a time when we are facing difficult issues, that someone who's not a citizen of this country stood bravely at the top of those escalators and stopped this perpetrator from getting onto another floor and potentially inflicting further carnage.
Kate, we're also learning more chilling details about Joel Cauchy and his final movements. There are claims he did have a fixation with knives and of killings. We've also heard claims that he was reported in other Westfields in the last few weeks, namely Penrith and Parramatta. Police are now looking into those claims to see if they can confirm those details. Kate?
Hayley Francis at Westfield Bondi, thank you. And the attacks at Bondi and Wakeley have prompted the US Embassy to issue a travel warning to Americans travelling to Australia, telling them to be vigilant and practice sound personal security.